हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल स्टडी जोन, नेवर स्टॉप लर्निंग। आज मैं आपको क्लास 10 सोशल साइंस 75 इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस के सॉल्यूशंस कराऊंगी। चलिए शुरू करते हैं आंसर वन से। द सॉल्ट मार्च विच टुक प्लेस फ्रॉम मार्च टू अप्रैल 1930 इन इंडिया वॉज एन एक्ट ऑफ सिविल डिसोबीडियंस लेड बाय मोहनदास गांधी हु प्रोटेस्ट ब्रिटिश रूल इन इंडिया। During the march, thousands of Indians followed Gandhi from his religious retreat near Ahmedabad to the Arabian Sea coast, a distance of some 240 miles. Answer 2. The HDI is calculated as the geometric mean equally weighted of life expectancy, education and GNI per capita as follows. The education dimension is the arithmetic mean of the two education indices, mean years of schooling and expected years of schooling. Answer 3. The value of the final goods and services produced in each sector during a particular year provides the total production of the sector for that year. Thus, GDP is the sum value of the final goods and services of the three sectors, primary, secondary as well as tertiary, produced within a country during a particular year. Answer 4. Resource planning is a complex process in India because of the following reasons. Resource planning involves first identifying of resources which are available in different parts of the country. This is not an easy process as it involves surveying and mapping various regions of the country. Answer 5. Chota Nagpur Plateau region has the highest concentration of iron and steel industries due to the following reasons. This region has vast reserves of coal and iron ore. Also, iron ore is cheaply available in this region, thus providing the raw material for iron and steel industries. Answer 6. Surface cover and runoff. Surface cover is a major factor to control erosion because it reduces the impact of raindrops falling on bare soils and wind removing soil particles. It also reduces the speed of water flowing over the land. Erosion risk is significantly reduced when there is more than 30% soil cover. Answer 7. Features of developed countries are high per capita income, low incidence of poverty, high standard of living, narrow income inequalities, low growth rate of population, low level of unemployment, infrastructural capabilities are present. Answer 8. Development is a healthy sign or improvement in the economic, political and social aspects of a nation. Two aspects of development are economic growth or increase in people's income, social progress including literacy, health and the provision of public services. Answer 9. The agricultural and allied sector services are known as the primary sector. The manufacturing sector is known as the secondary sector. The service sector is known as the tertiary sector. Raw materials for goods and services are provided for the primary sector. Answer 10. Agenda 21 is a non-binding action plan of the United Nations with regard to sustainable development. It is an action agenda for the UN, other multilateral organizations and individual governments around the world that can be executed at local, national and government levels. Answer 11. Rigor soil is that soil which is made up of extremely fine, that is, clay material. Features are capacity to hold moisture that makes it ideal for growing cotton, rich in soil nutrients such as calcium carbonate, magnesium, potash and lime. Answer 12. In the paintings of Frederick Soriot, the people of Europe and America marching in a long line are paying homage to the Statue of Liberty. This shows that they wanted and appreciated the principles of liberty, equality and fraternity. Answer 13. The French revolutionaries took many important steps to create a sense of collective identity among the French people, which were a new French flag, a tricolor replaced the royal standard, the States General was renamed the National Assembly and was elected by a group of active citizens. Answer 14. They all came united in 1848 to create a nation state out of the numerous German states, but the monarchy and the military members got together to repress them and they gained support from the landowners of Prussia, the Junkers as well. Prussia then became the leader of the German unification movement. Answer 15. The idea of Satyagraha basically emphasized the power of truth and the demand to search for truth. It suggested that if the cause was true, if the struggle was against injustice, then the physical force was not necessary to fight the oppressor. Answer 16. Gandhiji decided to withdraw the non-cooperation movement due to various incidents of violence perpetrated by the masses, especially the Chauri Chaura incident in 1922, where the people clashed with the police, setting a police station on fire. Answer 17. Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Jallianwala, also spelled Jallianwala, also called massacre of Amritsar incident on 13 April 1919, in which British troops fired on a large crowd of unarmed Indians in an open space known as the Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar in the Punjab region, now in a Punjab state of India, killing several hundred people and wounding many hundred more. It marked a turning point in India's modern history in that it left a permanent scar on Indo-British relations and was the pillar to Mohandas Mahatma Gandhi's full commitment to the cause of Indian nationalism and independence from Britain. Answer 18. Otto von Bismarck was a conservative Prussian statesman who dominated German and European affairs from the 1860s until 1890. In the 1860s, he engineered a series of wars that unified the German states significantly and deliberately, excluding Austria into a powerful German empire under Prussian leadership. Answer 19. The crown on the allegory of Germania signifies heroism. The crown worn by Germania is made up of olive leaves and the personification of Germany. The Germania is seen wearing it. She is a significance and symbol of nationality to the Germans and portrays the whole Germany as one. Answer 20. Political leaders differed sharply over the question of separate electorates because of differences in opinion, while those supporting the cause of minorities and the Dalits believed that only political empowerment would resolve their social backwardness. Others, like Gandhiji, thought that separate electorates would further slow down the process of their integration into society. Also, it was feared that the system of separate electorates would gradually divide the country into numerous fragments because every community or class would then ask for separate representations. Answer 21. Everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs, provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally acceptable, can be termed as resource. Examples: coal, water, air, minerals, and etc. Answer 22. Resources can be classified in the following ways: A. On the basis of origin, biotic and abiotic; on the basis of accessibility, renewable and non-renewable; on the basis of ownership, individual, community, national and international; D. On the basis of status of development, potential, developed, stocked and reserves. Answer 23. Resources obtained from the biosphere, like forest, wildlife, fisheries, livestock, human beings, etc., which have life, are called biotic resources. Iron, copper, gold, and lead are abiotic resources. Answer 24. Solar energy. Sunlight is one of our planet's most abundant and freely available energy resources. Wind energy. Wind is a plentiful source of clean energy. Answer 25. As potential resources are the resources that are present in a specific area and can be used in the future, developed resources are all those reserved and defined for their quality and quantity. Stock is the resource for which presently we don't have any technology to extract them. Reserve resources are those which we are not extracting them at present in spite of technological availability they are stored to meet world's future requirements. Answer 26. Sri Lanka has the more better performance regarding the human development than India. Sri Lanka is the island of the nation of South India in the Indian Ocean. Answer 27. The United Nations Development Programme is the full form of UNDP. And UNREGA full form is National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Answer 29. Body Mass Index BMI is defined as the weight in kilograms divided by the square of the height in meters. Body Mass Index is used to find out in an adult is that an adult is overweight or undernourished adults. It is an index developed by the nutrition scientist. BMI can be calculated by the following given steps. Measure the weight of the person in kilogram, measure the height of person in meter, divide the weight by the square of the height. If BMI is more than 25, then a person is considered overweight. If BMI is less than 18.5, then the person is considered undernourished. Mohit's BMI. Mohit's weight is 65 kg. Mohit's height is 1.4 meter. Square of Mohit's height 1.4 root 2 is equal to 1.96. Mohit's BMI is Mohit's weight upon square of Mohit's height, that is 1.4 meter whole square. Mohit's BMI is 65 upon 1.96. Mohit's BMI is 33.16. So आप यहाँ clearly देख सकते हैं कि मोहित की जो BMI निकली है वो overweight है, above 25 है. So इसलिए he is overweight because his BMI is more than 25. Answer 30. Rohan works in the organized sector and is therefore entitled to various kinds of benefits and allowances. Workers in the organized sector enjoy security of employment. They are expected to work only a fixed number of hours, and in case of any overtime duty, they are to be paid extra. At the time of retirement, they are also awarded pensions. Rohan as a bank clerk will also get paid leave payment during holidays, provident fund, gratuity, etc., along with medical benefits. Additionally, the employer in this sector under the law is expected to ensure facilities like clean drinking water and a safe working environment. Sumit's work in the unorganized sector and is therefore deprived of many benefits in comparison to the organized sector. The unorganized sector is categorized by small and scattered units which are largely outside the control of the government. Although there are certain rules and regulations, they unfortunately are not allowed. Job insecurity is a major problem with no provision for overtime, paid leave, holidays or leave due to sickness. Ye unorganized sector ka hai. Additionally, the worker might be asked to leave at any point in time due to seasonally nature of work or according to the whims of the employer in this sector. The organized sector in comparison to the unorganized sector offers better conditions of work and job security along with allowances for the benefits and well-being of its employees. However, the unorganized sector does not follow any rules or regulations that have been laid down by the government and therefore offers a seasonal, risky and insecure job. Answer 31. Amrita, a government employee who belongs to a rich urban household, would be successful in getting a loan from a formal source as compared to Rani, who comes from a poor household and works as a helper on a construction site. This is because there are certain terms of credit which need to be fulfilled in the formal sector. Those are as follows. Collateral, it is an asset that the borrower owns, example land, building, livestock, vehicles, etc., and uses as a guarantee to a lender until the loan is repaid. If the borrower fails to repay the loan, the lender can obtain his payment by selling that particular asset. Documentation. A formal source of credit functions according to certain rules and regulations in extending loans. They demand a set of formal documents of the borrower for identity and security purposes. The interest rate charged on loans along with the mode of repayment is also specified in formal documents. Financial capability. The formal source of credit needs to ensure the financial independence of the borrower. The poor often fail to get loans from these sources because of the lack of various terms of credit. Answer 32. Money helps to facilitate trade because people in the economy generally recognize it is valuable. Money is called medium of exchange because money is a widely accepted token that can be used for exchange of any good or service. In old days, barter system was used as a medium of exchange and later it was gold. Answer 33. The condition when both the parties in a barter system have to agree to sell and buy each other's commodity is known as double coincidence of wants. The initial difficulty in barter is to find two persons whose disposable possessions suit each other's wants. Answer 34. The accommodative experience of Belgium for peace and harmony is explained below. The constitution of Belgium has an equal number of Dutch and French speaking ministers in the central government. Brussels has a separate government in which both the community have equal representation. Answer 35. Horizontal distribution of power. The power is shared among the different organs of government such as the legislature, executive and judiciary. Example, the distribution of power between Indian Parliament, legislature, the Council of Ministers headed by Chief Minister, Executive and Courts of India. Answer 36. The mayor presides over the meetings of the municipal corporation. बाकी के आंसर्स मैं आपको नेक्स्ट वीडियो में पढ़ाऊंगी. अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आई हो तो इसे लाइक सब्सक्राइब शेयर करना ना भूलें और अगर आपको इसमें कोई भी डाउट हो तो कमेंट बॉक्स में डाल दें. थैंक यू.